time.
Yeah, they banned the Beastmaster. I think that's the most suiting. Like you were saying, just focus on Bulba.
Yeah, but in the last match, I mean, they were able to take advantage a little bit of that Batrider matchup in the top lane. Bulma, yeah. maybe with a little bit of a misplay, underestimating his mana pool, overestimating his mana pool early in the game, but still, I thought he had a pretty good impact on the game in spite of that.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I mean, Rappel made it a lot easier, but he did have some good pickups, some good awareness.
So Phoenix maybe not that big a deal because they have the Ursa to kill the egg.
Right.
I think Phoenix is not in the best place, is it? I mean, for team fight lamps, I think it's good. For the Sunray combos, I think it's a lot weaker. The damage is just not what it used to be.
DC they block the That's a really nice. They're going to take away the bat.
So that's safe lane void?
Yeah. Could, you know, I think it could be Resolution Morana, Wii mid, Batrider too. He plays bad.
He plays bad?
Yeah, he plays bad. I've seen him play bad a few times. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's actually pretty good.
Leaving it open. Okay, cool.
So Secret Seed is like, okay, Bulba, there's what, Tide left in the pool, there's
Tide.
Slardar, but again, like,
There's Tide and Tide.
Slardar is still a viable option. I think that was really, I don't think that was on Bulba in game one. I really don't.
No,
I think,
it was definitely a playstyle issue to me.
Yeah, I think that was what Fogg was saying, that they should have given him a little bit more farm priority early on. Yeah.
I think it's obviously not in the best versus the Void in that essence, but counter-initiating the Batrider, being able to crack and shell off the arrow in those situations. Yeah.
But bad versus Chrono.
The bad was Chrono.
Got two out of three. Can't win them all.
Not much left either.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's as I said, I think when I'm drafting for Bulba, it's always about autonomy. I just want to give him a hero that he can, if he has to, can go be on an island with.
I want to see Disruptor for DC. I actually think it combos well with the Face of Void. Very good versus Tidehunter.
That's not a bad idea.
I also think it's really good versus Defensive Disruption. So like Ursa can't pop his Enrage, like stuff like that.
Yeah. It's fallen out of favor heavily. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's another thing. The meta has shifted so rapidly since Manila. Fnatic were first picking Disruptor.
That hero had like a 75% win rate at Manila, too. And it just was like, I was like, okay, we're going to nerf the linger effect of Static Storm. And now it's unpicked because of the new hero picks.
I don't think it was quite. Yeah, it was very, very high at the main event. And it ended up overall, I believe, being the most picked hero at the tournament.
Yeah.
I also like Wyvern for DC. I think like they need better ways to kite their Ursa, and it also like it owns TA. I think in the team fight, I think their team fight will be like just amazing versus Secret.
I like Soxa's Wyvern as well.
Yeah, exactly. Soxa plays one of the better ones, and it's a cool setup. It's in a way for like the Void, the Morana, and stuff. If you don't want them to be the initial,
and then Fire and Ice.
Yeah, Fire Ice combo, and then some stars.
And then some time.
And then some time. Travel. All the dimensions and elements.
There it is. Yeah, Ben Wu.
Good call.
It just makes so much sense in that lineup.
Hmm.
So Secret, if form holds, probably going to be looking for Puppy's hero here. Enchantress is still on the table.
Omni Knight. Venge, maybe.
Yeah, Venge seems okay.
Venge good versus Bat and Void. Maybe like don't want to be super reliant on SD, I think, but I don't know.
Let's say they can pick Arteezy's here because it's like DC have last pick anyway, so that you don't need to hide his hero worrying about him getting countered because DC have overall last pick.
Illusion Benefiter and Alchemist overall very like tanky hero. You kind of want to have heroes to just blow him up in an instant manner. DC's heroes don't really have high burst.
Ban AA, I guess, here for your Secret.
I'd be down with that.
Probably needed.
I mean, AA with Void, you've got great setup for the Ice Blast.
Does kind of leave you with two iffy laning supports if you go AA here, but...
I mean, you can crush your tri-lane with AA Disruptor. Like, you can't go near AA Disruptor tri-lane.
That's true.
Neither support can help out the mid lane.
Yeah. I still like the Ench Ban, but you see. I thought they were going to take that fourth.
I think the AA Ban, though, is fair. It's good versus Titan lane. Good versus Alchemist through all stages. It's even pretty good versus Ursa. Canceling the blink.
Morana can't even harass Alk at all. You got like poor man shield there, and lane is just easy for Alk to farm in.
Yep.
There it is. Makes all right, so are we going to go back to something like the Coddle of the Omni, or are we going to take the more conventional Venge?
I'm down with Venge.
Yeah, Omni Knight.
Venge isn't really a puppy hero, though.
Yeah,
it's not. But after a certain, after you played Dota for so many years, isn't everything a puppy here?
Yeah. What else is there though?
It's CM, I guess, but I don't really like that.
CM's alright. Not great.
It's okay, but it's not.
But yeah, I mean, the standard, the obvious is Venge, the more puppy out of the ordinary, I guess you could say, the Coddle, the Omni Knight.
Dazzle with Shadow Demon? That's a good Dazzle. Like, those two supports work well together, although we've seen Secret Jewel and they haven't actually used their supports kind of in tandem so much.
They do like the Dazzle Tide off. Yeah. I've seen them run out a fair amount.
Well, that's what I was thinking, like, what hero can go offlane with Tide, because that's been the go-to for Secret so far. They may change that based on, like, seeing a... Well, it's Disruptor. It's not the strongest safe lane for now for DC, but...
No, that's a good point. They have not been all about the Iron Talon in this series, to the point even where they had Bulba start without the Calling Bead in Game 1 on Slaughter.
They could even potentially still have, like, a dual, pseudo-aggro dual tri-lane in Tidehunter in the safe lane. They've done that for Bulba yesterday. Don't know if they'll want to do that entirely yet, though, but... Possibility.
Still a concern with me when I look at this lineup about Ursa and Alchemist just being kited. A lot of control on the side of DC.
Could always do like Enigma if you're worried about that. But
so the greed has been Secret's undoing has been the main issue.
Yeah. But I mean, they picked Alchemist, so.
Yeah, but I mean, like picking another greedy here, like picking a jungler with the Alchemist to me sounds like a bad idea.
It does.
I guess Enigma, you can get your fast mech and then just stop jungling.
Call it Ven. I believe in you.
I don't know, man.
Come on, Ven.
I said Ven, but... Ven seems like the standard one.
Oh, come on,
that
Ven.
Is not what I expected.
I expected you to say that.
Ben. The Alk Venno. Early pool
Ven and Venno are right next to each other in the hero pick, so he was as close as you can get, you know?
Venomancer.
That's a jungler with Iron Talon.
It can be.
It jungles super fast.
Yeah.
But it is.
Is he good at zoning
bizarre.
Void?
I think Shadow Demon will be
Shadow
in that.
Demons, yeah.
I don't think you need to commit all three heroes.
So where's Venno gonna go? Offlane?
With the tide?
Offlane or jungle?
One of the two, I guess.
Yeah. Helping mid a little?
Because remember, the damage type changes mean that the wards do a ton of damage to neutrals.
Yeah. Support Morana, it looks like.
Wow. All
right. Whoa.
Okay.
Healing. More Venno wards are up at the same time. Okay, versus it too.
Mm-hmm.
But
I'm a little thrown here by the last couple of picks that changed the draft a lot from what I thought.
Venomancer in this game.
Who do you think takes this?
Oh man.
Yeah.
Coin flip?
I don't get a coin. It's for
I'm really not too like I'm not too sure. The Venomancer pick really throws off like everything I was kind of thinking about, but I like DC's draft this game. I think the Disruptor pick was really really cool. I think that's the cool thing, but they do lack a bit of burst for the Alchemist. So it's really a toss up for me. I'm really not too sure.
If Misery can hit arrows on mid, I think that's gonna be key. Like you can win that mid lane with Batrider Roman.
Here, just because I'm never going to run this Venno. I'm not sure how they're going to get a lot of value in the early game. But with that, guys, last game of the day. So one more time, let's throw it over to our casters, Gods and Merlini.
All right, welcome everyone to the final game 3 decided between DC and Team Secret. Winner goes through to the top 3 of the tournament. Loser drops down to the lower bracket.
Okay, so I don't see any Iron Talon. No Iron Talon yet from Venno, but he does have 575 gold.
He's considering. Oh, Woods on the Courier.
Venno.
Yep. Talon. There we go.
And the Venno. Is that a Venno courier?
Venno courier for the Venno pick?
What
no.
What is that courier?
Is that a little lizard?
Hover over the name.
October.
To the right. Right of the boots. Yeah. Atrophic Skitter.
Skitterwing.
TI6 courier.
What on earth? But you knew your cosmetics, Ben.
That's super new, man. I don't know what that one is. I know most of them. Where's your bit of boat, Tidehunter? Where's your squiddles? Where's your pirate hat? Where's your shark cape?
Cosmetic game not on point.
I mean, Envy and RTZ are all about the cosmetics, though.
Puppy normally is. He's got like the level like 3000 compendium or something.
Yeah.
Bounty runes, one apiece, Alchemist Batrider, and Misery's, his ability to find arrows slash courier kills.
He wants to find out what the Venom's up to. Yeah. I think like that's your main jungle. Because you're not sure, it could be zoning out bottom, could be double lane top, could be jungle, and now they confirm jungle.
Does he... I mean, it's kind of hard to get in there and fight the Venom, like you're Mirana, you need your level 2 to have leap and arrows. So
you can farm the wards though. Like you can just right click them down twice and then you'll... Like that slows down farming a lot.
Could have, I mean, you could go between those tier 1 and tier 2 towers mid, but then you're spotted going through there, so.
I mean, you can't really kill him, though, because Venno has level 1 wards, and then Alk is going to go greed at level 1.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely could have just walked on through in plain sight. He could have blocked the camp with his wards and farmed some wards, but.
I'm curious to see what Misery's going to do, so.
Yeah.
I think he's trying to invade now that he has confirmed jungle. So I don't know if Puppy's gonna get level 2 before this happens. Once if he does get level 2, then might be somewhat of a hassle for him.
He's heading bottom rather than invading.
Yeah. Okay, he's already level 2. Yeah. Good luck with that.
Okay. Like you say. Instead, he's gonna prioritize this bottom lane. Pi did get XP for that, I believe. Yeah, so he split the XP and got level 2 off of that, so not the end of the world. Mirana showing herself this bottom lane. So the good news for Secret is, if anything, half the battle for Secret is just knowing where Mirana is on the map here in the early game. If Arteezy doesn't have to worry about arrows, he can just farm away in this mid lane.
And same with, you have to be able to mat the jungler in some sense. Like, either have a greedy jungler of your own, or keep chain pulling up top, or kill one of the lanes, or contest one of the jungles. Those are your main options, and Misery's not really able to do any of that right now, unless they get a kill on Ursa or severely hinder his farm.
Void Mirana, not the most potent of killing duos pre-level 6.
At all. And Puppy, it looks like he is trying to make a move for that rune in Misery.
Oh, he's got level 2 though, so. Could force a leap out here if you're Puppy, although no Venomous Gale, so. We'll get Misery out of there, and yeah, I mean, it's a support Mirana game. Normally you think of support Mirana as just kind of scary imposing their presence on that mid lane with arrows, but.
Nope. They can also scout them constantly with the plague wards.
Yep.
200 HP on those things? Dang. That's a lot of right clicks.
Especially for a support Mirana.
Yep.
But Arteezy isn't going to have the best time mid because of it being a bat right. I like that they didn't send the Mirana mid because I feel like that would be a free farm lane for Alchemist. Instead, they give Alk a tougher matchup. Speaking of rotations, here comes Misery. There's the leap once again, and Alk nearby, but Alk's not even stopping to farm as he finds a safety camp.
He has blocked one camp, though. That's pretty important. You can slow down his rotation a lot, and he can't just drop all the wards on the left side and chain pull him between those two.
So, leap on out. What do you make of this first couple of minutes as far as the lanes and what the two teams are trying to do?
Venno's getting a lot, and he's been disrupted slightly with the one observer ward, but he's still almost level 4, 3 minutes in, and... I think that the only thing that's a little bit worrisome, as you mentioned, is Alchemist not free farming in the mid lane, but I think it's okay. They can get the Venno to just sit in lanes and make space and just push towers with ward pretty safely while the Alchemist farms in the jungle later, so I'm not terribly concerned about the Alchemist.
No. I mean, Alk is not necessarily relying on that good early game CS. Find a bounty rune or two, you're happy, and...
Yeah.
Top lane Tide hasn't been zoned out as well. He's getting XP at least. Both off lane is getting XP, but Misery on the move. We'll be probably looking to hit an arrow on this mid lane sometime soon, but Pi already in position for this one.
We already know. He's already on the left side. Actually, they might get a kill. They saw him
with
the
wards. Can they turn this around? The arrow not going to land on anyone. We in trouble. Going to turn around. Flame Break has the fairy fire, but he goes down. And it will be a return kill on Alchemist thanks to the... Well, not really thanks to Misery, that was just all the Batrider. There's Pylai Dai now in some trouble, he doesn't have disruption, he's just gonna spend some money, hold position. And a 2-for-1 in exchange. I think it's alright for DC in return, not really the most influential exchange of kills, all things considered, in the end.
Did Misery get XP for that out kill? I don't think so.
Maybe not, actually. He's still pretty high level, but that could that's probably just from some of the jungle.
I actually think it was from him. Okay. Because he only got the one troll creep, and then aside from that, he hadn't really got anything. Yeah, I think he did get XP, so.
Has that's a win. Boots all of a sudden, so. He can fire arrows very freely now.
Or farm jungle very freely. that ward, though, I'm very surprised that we died there. I think his position was pretty good, but they should have been able to see the Shadow Demon.
I think he's somewhat underestimating the damage output, perhaps, too. Like, he knew Misery's there, and he's like, okay, I'll bait. It's one of those...
But he can't run away. Them, but... He can't run away from Gale.
Yeah.
You can TP out.
Well, you're perhaps not expecting the Gale to be leveled up. Did he add Gale at level 4?
Yeah, he did.
Okay. He kind of actually called they use Gale for that, that kill.
Yeah, he normally uses Firefly run away, but... Yep, that's what killed him.
So...
Bulba, arrow will land from afar, and... Resolution with the Blade Fury taking a lot of damage under this tower. Has a salve and... Oh! Had to use it and also immediately have it taken out.
I wonder if he could have used his healing salve to tank that less... Or healing ward to take that lesson in the salve. That would have been pretty greedy. That was definitely the safer play.
If you do that and you die, then kick yourself a bit, but...
But efficiency, dude.
I mean, the healing... Or level 1 healing ward, so it won't be full HP, I guess.
Yeah. Efficiency.
I mean, he's gonna get full HP anyway, so it's the same end result, isn't it?
Not full.
Yeah, he's got the mango HP regen. It's okay, Ben. give it like a minute and a half.
I'm just thinking about max efficiency, man.
He could have just not used the salve at all if he saved himself with a healing ward. Would that be max efficiency? And then sell your healing salve later on.
Money, money, money.
Yeah. Puppy takes over mid lane, and
yeah, this is you can't really gank the Venno at this point, and that's like he's just super annoying. Like you have to throw a lot of resources to kill him, and yeah, you can like technically maybe farm the wards, but level 3 wards are very difficult to kill, and he just isn't worth it to kill. He's like I don't know, what do you call those, parasites, something?
Parasites, sure.
Well, parasites are worth it to kill. There's like bugs that aren't like worth it to kill. I don't know. It's kind of like, you know, those insects
gnats.
in the wild,
like
that
gnats,
are poisonous.
Kind of? Poisonous, I think you want to stay away from them, but...
Yeah, it's not worth it to kill. It's like,
flies.
Oh.
I mean, the flies, you don't have to kill flies. They just... I mean, I'm from Australia, you go to the beach and there's like flies all over you, and you just kind of shrug them off.
That works.
He's annoying.
Yeah, it's just not worth it. It's like, just let it live.
Yep.
Just let it do its thing. Now he has a raindrop on top of that, but if you don't, then you can't go to the jungle without smoking, and you have to smoke through bottom. So like the avenue of ganking the alchemist is going to be very low. On top of that, they had the Tidehunter farm of the ancients. So like you, with the Venno parked here, you can't access either of those areas, and Misery looking for something right here. And then if you don't deal with this threat, your tower is going to get pushed down. So like you have three things you need to worry about, but first it has to be the Venno.
I'm not even sure he's looking for a kill there unless the TP came in.
He's level 7. That's absurd.
That with drums, but good luck drumming through the Plague Ward field. Misery, not the highest level. He did get his first point in Starstorm. I imagine he'll go back and start leveling this up now and prioritizing some farm on himself.
Probably not what he wanted to do in the early game, but...
Ooh, can they get the glimpse? Yes, they can. Nice TP from Sansa.
Oh no, the arrow missed because of the flame break. And now...
Puppy's gonna survive. That's a level 1 Starstorm. Mistakes were made.
No. Mistakes were made, indeed. And...
That was a clever TP, though. I like the idea, just not the execution.
Mm-hmm.
Void treads Ring of Regen, so he's getting some farm. 32 CS on Void. He's... quite farmed, indeed. I mean, CS and farm-wise, it's actually going alright for DC. Tide's not getting all too much.
Far more versus Alchemist.
Yeah. I mean, right now it's even, but we all know how this ends up if you don't start playing aggressive.
And they can do Roche at some point too. Like, beat down the mid T1 with Venno, switch him over to bottom, beat down that mid, or that T1, and then... Like, especially like if they have Tidehunter sitting behind the Venno, like, just don't want to go on that.
Haven't seen much from Jackie Mao and the Ursa just yet, but probably trying to just work on his Blink Dagger. We'll see if he gets the mask, but for the most part we've seen him just rush Blink.
They can't stop his Enrage unless they get a Chronosphere on him, and Venno is ready to be annoying and tank the gank.
He's always, wherever DC try and make a move, Venno's there with his frickin' wards.
Yeah.
And they've got to not have... Oh, they're going to go in a Puppy. That'll work. There's the arrow set up. It's not the biggest kill because Envy's... He's out of there.
He's still pretty good kill because he's very high level.
I know, if you can get a tier 1 tower for this, it pays. Taking that bottom tier 1 radiant tower opens up their entire jungle. It helps you control Roche later on, so it is a very important objective in general.
So we going for this.
Three stacks and counting.
Back gets the lasso, but here's Tide, and It's a tie with a Ravage, so.
That did not look close.
No.
He couldn't. I mean, he didn't commit for it once he sees the tide, I guess.
Yeah, that's a lot of mana loss, though. Yeah. Like, using Lasso for not a kill is not efficient. At least he got some heroes to do stuff.
Rezo has the Omni Slash. Envy pulled back. Is there a Static Storm? You betcha. He does preemptively ultimate. I'm not going to be able to TP out. Resolution will slice and dice. Down goes the Ursa.
As you mentioned, they're not respecting the glimpse. Both in mid lane, both in top lane, and I think these are actually playing very well against the Alchemist. They've gotten very important kills. I think Venno can be considered a core at this point.
They should have killed him once more too, if not for a slight misplay. So DC's making the right moves.
And they're keeping very close to net worth. I would say Alchemist, like, ideally, I think it's like 3,000 in the first 10 minutes is kind of where your net worth is supposed to be expected if it's like a even farm game. And I think DC are not that far behind in terms of net worth, so that's good.
Probably gonna be working on the mech. So this last game on Omniknight, same story with different hero here. DC didn't take the bottom tier on tower since they rotated to help by resolution. They're now trying to work on this top tower. Can he get out of this one? Blade Fury and the kinetic field will cover his retreat. So likely a tower deny for Secret. Not the biggest deal for DC. We'll lose out on a bit of money here. Is Moo gonna stop that Plague Ward spam? Try and plant your Plague Wards now. Alright, he still can. There we go, deny tower. Whoa, that's a big stack. Mm. Who'd you rather get this? I mean, I guess you just, whoever gets it takes it.
Definitely RTZ, because Radiance, and then, like, you create space for your other members.
Yeah.
So, yeah, how's our net worth graph looking?
After that, it's probably going to swing up back to even, I would say. That was like 1,000 gold worth of ancients.
Very good for DC. They are farming extremely well. We especially.
Look at Void. Void 2 is 50 CS. I guess Tide's caught up a bit now, but...
It's hard to outmatch Grievel's Greed, but they're doing it at the moment.
Helped up by a few kills here. Relic just about complete. There we go. So 12-minute Relic. Often you see that kind of 13, 14-minute Radiance Armlet. It's a little bit slower than that perhaps right now, but... Drum going to help push this tower down. DC really want to start taking objectives, knowing that it's only going to get harder as time goes on and Alchemist gets that Radiance, then Manta, then Octarine up.
Haste rune on bottom. I think Puppies maybe saw it. Doesn't look like he dropped a Plague Ward to kill it.
And we're seeing here, there's not been a Ravage yet, but we're seeing the benefit of the Tide pickup over like the game one Slaughter. All it takes is Bulba to show up, and then suddenly DC gets scared and back off it. Oh, Envy. Uh-oh. Whoa, uh-oh. Walks on out.
That looked like it was gonna hit.
Yeah. That was one of the more dubious kinetic field escapes I've seen. But just having the Tide Ravage is very much something that DC respecting. When they go for Tower's objectives, or Wii was when he was looking for the kill in Alk, as soon as they see the Tide, it's like, okay, back off. This guy can completely ruin our day. Whereas a Slaughter without a blink, you're not that scared of him.
Does Wii not see that Haste Rune? And regardless, he will look for a kill on Puppy and drops the ultimate in response. Move pretty low, but doesn't have to worry about the Poison Nova. And he is okay.
Yep. That works out just fine.
Haste rune, bat with haste is so good.
He's gonna blink.
But it's so good versus Venom.
It's gonna expire
Venom.
Now. Oh no.
And Demonic Purge.
We can purge it off, but yeah, you can use after the purge. So, Radiance o'clock coming for the Alchemist. There we go.
Yeah.
Okay. I was like, hey, it's gonna finish this double stack. I'm like, no, it'll get sped up. Easy bounty rune. But Moo already on the move again, has a Chronosphere, and the Blink Dagger surprises there for Bat, but without a Lasso, no guarantees of a kill here. Chrono into Arrow could potentially be the set they're looking for, but Venno will scout it out with the Plague
Or
Ward.
Just Blink Lasso from the south. That's where Bat Rider's headed. He's looking for Bubby.
He's on cooldown though.
Oh, okay.
30 seconds and...
Blink Flame Break! Excellent. I don't know if he wants to use Flame Break.
Secret's looking to fight. This is an interesting movement considering, I mean, Alk is Radiance, but that does not mean he's ready to fight by any means.
They're going to meet at the rune. Looks like we, expecting a Roche, will grab it and pop it, but the Observer Ward has...
Gets out too.
Oh my goodness.
Good Fast Fingers and no Firefly, but the Moonlight Shadow helps cover them and Misery sees... Oh, Saxa sees everything. And elsewhere, it's Puppy, caught out. We've seen him a few times get caught like this. They don't mind committing a chrono for him. As you kind of mentioned, he is kind of playing a core role with how much farm he's getting.
Not anymore.
Static Storm with the Kinetic Field. They get both. Lasso goes on to Jackie Mao. They want to bring down the Ursa first. Gets the Enrage off, and it looks like Resolution slowed down by the Demonic Purge. Ravage comes out, catches three, but it's under the T1 tower, so Secret can't really fight this one, and we'll look to retreat here. Batrider blinks in, trying to slow people down. No Omni Slash available for Juggernaut, as he is short on mana.
That Lasso maybe came out a little bit too early. Perhaps he was scared of the defensive disruption, but there was a lot of overlap, and they will get a kill. But I think that's a big benefit for DC because they wasted they use Ravage.
Oh, yeah, if anything, yeah. I mean, DC used their ultimates as well, but they can take objectives. Like, yeah, Secret are much more reliant on Ravage. Oh, Puppy!
Wow, Napalm plus Arrow, can't dodge Arrow.
They break into Firefly. Well played, and they get the glimpse. Talked about people not respecting the glimpse, and we'll see it a bit more here.
That's the chain feed. That's the chain feed.
This perhaps bound to happen sooner or later.
Well, it's close to that point, but now it's all about the Alk. I don't think they can contest Roche at this point, DC. They have the Vlad's ready, they have the healing ward, they have the physical damage to take it down. They've taken down the T1, so I think they're in the clear for that. Mm-hmm. So now it's time to think about how they want to address the Alk. Do they even need to think about addressing the Alk? He's the only one that's going to be a problem, it seems like. Yeah,
a threat, I think late game they actually have a chance to beat him. Misery, I was about to say, I saw his net worth, I was like, Misery must be close to an Acceptor.
Oh,
so
my.
They've got a full position Mirana who's going to turn into a scary farm core hero. Well, Misery's going to be out farming the Void in no time at all.
Ursa's net worth is also very troublesome. It's quite low.
Yep. It's got the blink, but he's not been involved in a single kill, and you don't pick Ursa to farm, you pick Ursa to threaten to take Roche and threaten hero kills, and ideally not just threaten, but get those hero kills.
I'm actually surprised he went blink first, because I don't think it's very easy for him to kill any of the heroes. Like, you Void, Time Walks out, they have Leave, they have Spin away, they have the blink on the Batrider, which kind of dispelled their last smoke, so... Yeah, it's like I think his net worth is going to heavily struggle because of that. You don't get any kills, you don't get Roche, and then you don't have the farming lifesteal that you so desperately need.
You point this out, it's Secret unable to really contest Roche anymore, and with no Ravage and no point and no Venom ulti, this is going to be, it looks like an uncontested Roche. Ravage actually comes up now, so if I can get in fast enough, they could stop this, but Tide stops, so DC take Roshan immediately smoked themselves. They've got all their ultimates and they want to fight. Who are they going to catch out here off to the side? It's going to be Envy the Ursa. Caught in the Static Storm. That's only one ulti committed, so they've still got the lasso if they can find anyone else. And you betcha they can. Pylai die will delay the inevitable. And DC, very efficient. Hold the chrono, hold the lasso, hold the Omni Slash. And they've also got Misery farming top, so it's about as efficient as it can get. They're not even using everyone to find the Roshan, to find these kills.
And a couple TP things out that you mentioned before is like, the Secret's greed may be their undoing, and it seems like this is a kind of case in point, as well as I think Fog mentioned like the, like you just need a quick pace game, and DC have just been storming the T1s and invading the jungle, and
this could turn into an, I mean, we talk about they can deal with a super farmed alchemist, but you look at the super, like, not even super late game, but you look at an alchemist, if you defend high ground with Venna, with Plague Wards, you look at these heroes that you can pull acceptors to, it's pretty good. Venna with Ags, Ursa with Ags is not bad, you can get out of stuns, you can just kind of got that Abaddon ulti effect to it.
Four Ags heroes.
So, I don't want to say Secret out of this by any means, as underfarmed as everyone is compared to Arteezy, Arteezy can redistribute that wealth the longer this game goes.
I think Venno eggs is one of the best eggs.
Yeah.
Maybe not one of the best, but it's certainly like 60 or 70 percentile. Ursa eggs is also pretty decent. I would say like maybe 50th percentile. Demonic Purge, in particular, in some games it's like really, really strong, but this game there's not really anything to break.
Feeds continue as it looked like they were cutting the bottom lane as well for a kill. Envy will get pulled back and kept alive.
That was awkward.
Yeah,
not the best glimpse.
Mm-hmm. Secret now. Again, it's going to be all about Arteezy moving forward. At least at this stage, it's Arteezy keep farming, and then just defend high ground. Like DC can kind of threaten with the Juggernaut. He has Arteezy caught by an arrow, but doesn't look like there's follow up. But DC, we'll see how much damage they can just do as far as taking towers go.
I don't even think they need to take towers though, because they have all the tools to farm. They don't have the ultimate on resolution, but.
Yeah, without
Envy will make the first jump.
And the first TP in gets glimpsed back, so they could look to re-engage. Batrider without ultimate, 15 seconds, will have to disengage. I believe it's going to be a full on retreat here. Batrider, the invis wears off, but they don't have vision for the Alk stun, so Moog now going to be going in. Time walks over the cliff, catches out just Bulb in the Chronosphere, but they can kill him. That's going to take Ravage out of the picture, but it doesn't look like they've got anywhere near enough damage. DC, I believe it's going to be an all-out retreat for them at this stage. They're kind of low on mana and resources. Looks like they're not going to be able to continue fighting around this bottom tier 2. The sustain from the mech and the pipe helping Secret out there.
Yeah, definitely no reason to fight, so.
You can see, I think DC recognized, like, okay, this is going to be more of a farming game. They got Midas on Void, and they're going Battle Fury on Jug, so.
Moo could die here. Okay, JK.
JK, indeed. Trying to bait that Ravage. Like, if he doesn't time walk off that initial stun, it's a kill with Ravage if they're willing to commit Ravage.
Yeah. Nice fast fingers by DC, but Secret limited to one kill in 21 minutes.
Dota's not about kills, man. to some extent, it might be. If you're down like 0 to 20, I mean, if you're down 1 to 13, it kind of is. It tells part of the story.
I think the Morana is more fun than the Ursa, and I think it's going to stay that way.
Just wait for the Hag Scepter. That's like a plus 4k net worth right there. I mean, at some point,
you don't give it to Ursa first.
No, I guess depends how what you think's the priorities.
I think Venno first, then maybe Tide, I would say.
Ursa's is pretty nice, being able to use it out of the... Like, you can use it during Lasso, I guess, as well as the Arrow.
Can't use it during Static Storm or Chrono, so I think those are probably more likely to kill him.
I mean, hey man, Venno can't ulti during those stuns. Ursa can get his ulti off when he's there.
He can survive!
Yeah.
He can survive!
I mean, Venno's gonna play that, like, blink in, maybe just suicide kind of role. Arteezy in the front line took a lot of damage here. Rezo still has the Aegis. May just look to turn and fight. Arteezy can... Well, doesn't need to take the Omni Scythe. The disruption's there, and Bulba is gonna... turn around, holding onto the Ravage still. They could look to throw this one on Resolution's respawn. Misery's out of the fight. He's completely depleted of HP. Ravage comes out. Resolution going to go down. And talk about kills not mattering. Secret will get a very important kill. That one does matter because Rezo without buyback. Oh, we're down 1 to 13. Let's just push mid, get a kill, and break high ground with two kills, Ben.
That pipe value.
Well, is Secret actually breaking high ground at 23 minutes when down... 12 kills?
Definitely.
Okay. Just your everyday game at Dota 2. Okay, they'll back off now. That is an unexpected turn of events.
Shadowblade pickup is very nice. This is one of the best solutions to deal with the Venno wards if you need to bypass them. So you'll see. I like a lot. You don't see Venno very often, so it's not like an easy call to make, but I think it's very, very good.
What's he gonna find down here at bottom lane? Can he get vision of Puppy? Should be a kill here.
Needs lasso.
Yep.
But
and he'll have flame break if he needs that post lasso to stop a TP if Puppy tries for that. What's the play here, Puppy?
Pipe and buy one more second.
Didn't even pipe. Didn't even bother.
Buy his item.
Yeah, I was about to say, his option is either buy your item or pipe.
I guess he's probably going for four staff then, if he's buying the staff.
I don't think you go for Ags considering you've got the Alchemist who can. No, who's going to get super farmed.
I think Veil might be a better consideration for him. Yeah. But, not a big deal.
Even the Blink would be a good option when like you're against Void, you can maybe get away. I mean, you can split push and then when you just sense Bat's coming, you can blink away before he gets on top of you or blink away if you think Void's coming. So. See how things progress here. Arteezy almost has the Octarine.
Very farmed. 20,000 net worth.
And this is, I mean, your farm accelerates with Octarine, so he's only going to continue to get farm. It will transition less about being himself and more about the Ag Scepters. Well, it did blink already, but lacking the catch there.
Looks like Juggernaut might need a blink too. There's been a lot of fights where he's like kind of needs the mobility.
When Void's similar story where he went for this Midas, so he hasn't had a blink to get off the ideal Chronos in these last couple of fights. But the good news for DC, they've gone for farming items. So they've got four cores all with reasonable farm. Saxka couldn't get on the clip, but he can still TP away. Envy is just so poor. 1-2-0 Ursa. In terms of net worth, he's behind four enemy heroes.
Value Shadowblade.
Yep. But this game just has this ominous feel, like Secret's actually like in the position that they're okay being in right now. Despite the kill score, despite everything that's happened so far, it somehow just feels like Secret are remaining calm.
Yeah, and then Alcan, as you mentioned, pulls Scepters, so it's not like his net worth is going to be unmanageable once it gets to very large numbers.
I think DC recognizing they want to make something happen soon.
So they got to pick off the Shadow Demon early so they can actually kill the Alchemist and maybe drop a Shadow Storm on the Tidehunter depending on his position, but looks like Secret are already looking to get out of there and looks like the scan will miss.
Ooh, Secret smoke up themselves, but here come DC with numbers, but this is a really a must-win fight for DC in a lot of ways. Smoke will pop, and I think DC may reconsider this one. Off to the side is Mu. He's got to hit a big Chronosphere. They are grouped up right now, but he doesn't see them. They are still in the smoke. And DC, I think, realizing that Vision not really playing to their advantage, and Secret, once your smoke pops and Secret see you with the Venno wards, you've just got to kind of reconsider initiating.
And with Manta and SD illusions, they can constantly get Vision on the front lines with the super farmed Alchemist, and Arteezy may stun himself here.
He'll do so, but Ursa already takes out Mirana at the top, and they haven't got the damage to bring down Arteezy. He's just so tanky right now, and DC, unless they want to go all in there on Arteezy, don't really stand a chance to kill him.
Murano was already at like 35% before the fight, even real fight even started. So that's a byproduct of the Venom Wars and the Alchemist Illusions.
Well, goes back to the point, kills do not mean very much in some games of Dota, and this is definitely one of them. But surprised to be saying that considering there's an Ursa in the game. Normally you think of Ursa as a hero who needs kills, but this Ursa has not really been a factor this game, I would say. It's been much more about the Venom, the Alchemist, and what they can do as far as just being menaces on the map.
Wonder if they wish they had a Lion instead of Disruptor at this point.
Probably. I mean, the Disruptor got them those kills and got them the early game momentum, though. Like, you wouldn't get those with the Lion. Like, Disruptor gets it with levels. Lion needs his blink.
Mm-hmm.
Hagadim Scepter number one. When is that coming up? That's one of the questions you've got to ask. There's a courier. It's going to go for his own items first. So Shiver's Guard, and then you're effectively six slotted outside of the Moonshard. And effectively entering that kind of god tier of being absolutely unkillable.
Juggernaut needs a lot more items to compete with him. I think he's going to be the main damage dealer to the Alchemist. Well,
now, and I think recognizing that, that's why he goes for the armor option too with the Shivers. So there we go. Six slotted Alchemist, 28 minutes into the game. A few small tweaks you can make, of course, replacing things like Armlink, getting Moonshard, but we'll see what DC's move is going to be. And they've got this farm Mirana, so it's not all about one farm jug just for them. It's going to be tough. Maybe they can take advantage of Arteezy not building BKB, go for something like an E-Blade Mirana and try to just burst him down with nuke damage later on, get a Dagon, but
that's very difficult because they have the Shadow Demon to worry about. Like, the Shadow Demon disruption is like, he'll gain so much HP with his Chemical Rage inside, and it'll just interrupt the flow of the fight for DC, so they...
Someone's going to find Shadow, like you said, the Batrider or the Void has to catch. Like, committing a Chrono for Shadow Demon seems worth it to me.
Oh, hello, puppy. I don't think they can kill him, though. And I think that they have a problem where Batrider's actually not able to do that much damage anymore.
Well, Alk's saying, let's push high ground. You've hit this kind of critical mass of items, and no one really wants to engage and fight. You've also got Shadow Demon Illusions to help with this push. We can see them on the front lines with the Manta Illusions, and well, illusions on the illusion. Shadow Demon resummons some more. DC getting zoned out. You can't really rely on Blink Daggers when there's these Radiance Alk illusions on you, and Misery loses half of his HP, and at this point, DC's just slowly losing racks. Three kills, all it takes for Team Secret to find themselves in a position to break the high ground of DC. DC have to make a move at some point, and it's resolution split pushing the top lane.
Maybe they can find a small window where his chemical rage is down, but with Octarine Cord, it's only just a few seconds.
Exactly, it's a tiny window, and I think they're trying to force Secret back more than anything. Ursa has TP'd first.
Look at these places.
He's waiting for a follow-up TP, perhaps. Goes looking for a Bastion, knowing that Rezo can't TP, and I think he canceled the TP. That is not a TP to go for. Now Rezo is committed to this top lane, or he's going to start running back. Secret aren't breaking through just yet. Envy's job has been done. He's carried a TP scroll. He's defended the secret high ground.
I think these wards are and the Alka Illusions, though, are going to take down the Rex.
Bit by bit.
Yep.
Yeah, Range Rex for sure. That's not going to heal up. The melee Rex maybe will require a bit more effort, but I like the use to creep skip the top lane. You can farm the bottom lane as well. You can still like maintain some great efficient farm here.
Oh, man.
Oh, God. This is just dirty from Team Secret. If they like win this game with 3 kills, though.
And the corner in the Roach as the illusions and the plague wards are being mopped up by DC, and DC, they have to make a move. I don't even know if they're going to be in time to stop this Ursa.
Like you say, it's Ursa with minus armor. Gosh, acid spray. Can't even get here in time. Let's give Envy some leeway as far as breaking high ground. They committed a smoke to that. I feel like, if anything, you want to save that smoke for your high ground defense so you can bypass the Venom wards, but now they've committed the smoke and they're not going to get there in time for Roche. They're trying to fight this one. Moo, he's committed, but can't blink anywhere. Envy going to find Wii, and that's a dead Batrider. At this point, DC's just going to completely retreat, defend the high ground, use that Batrider buyback once Secret get there.
Oh, no.
They're going to lose Moo. His buyback likely to be forced out as well.
I think that could be the start of the end.
Yeah. Misery. Ravage on two. You've got to buy back, DC. They use one, but Mirana doesn't have one. They commit both buybacks, but this is, like you say, looking like the potential end for DC. Alchemist just unkillable. Resolution in the front lines. Cannot fight his way through this one. He manages to buy some time with the Mantis style to get off the Omni Slash. He's just chipping away at a few of these heroes and illusions. Looks like Secret will finally figure out where the real Juggernaut
is. How
was
that melee range?
Okay, well.
And with that,
Superman strategy.
Oh,
Manta
wow.
Dodge on Glimpse.
What Manta?
Well, that's 9k plays right there. Chrono just for an Aegis, and I think Arteezy can go back in. He's got, yeah, Chemical Rage once more, and your buddy Jackie.
He bought an axe for himself, so he's not looking to help him out that much.
What, Arteezy did?
No, Eternal Envy bought his own stuff.
Oh, okay. Oh, man, we talked about Secret maybe looking this game to rely on the Accept as being pulled to redistribute the worth, but no, not needed. Alchemist on his own.
I underestimated how poorly they can deal with the Alchemist.
Like, yeah.
Mainly because we haven't seen really Alchemist like win that many games recently. Like, a lot of teams have just been very good at stopping his flow and stopping his farm, but...
And the hero just seems to be too slow-paced in most of these games, but DC didn't do enough to pressure, I guess you could say. I mean, they found kills. They're up 13-1, remember.
And another challenger arises to partner up with Shadow Demon.
Yeah. Oh, man. All right, who's going to be the lucky duck? I guess Puppy?
Venno, yeah. I mean,
Ursa already has one, so...
I was playing with an Alchemist once, and he gave an axe to himself before he gave one to any of his teammates. I was so upset.
I was playing with Winter, and he was Alchemist, and he refused to pull me an Axe Scepter when he was 7 slotted, so, like...
SD. Okay, triple break.
Alright.
Very good at killing the Juggernaut. I guess, I mean, it's good at dealing with the Batrider, it's good at killing everyone. Why not?
Resolution. Turn and Omni Slash. It goes over to Arteezy, and he's a hero that does not care about it. We'll get helped out by the disruption. He's full HP as he comes out of that, and DC, they lasso up Envy, but what can they really do? What can they really kill? Well, the answer is very little, as Misery will be the first to fall. He'll immediately buy back. They haven't lost many heroes beyond that, but they've used every ultimate.
Yeah.
And they've done zero damage.
They are unkillable.
I mean, they just aren't doing enough damage.
I really like how often Puppy picks up the pipe, though. I think his effective HP is just ridiculous right now.
He's one of those players who's always by pipe and mech more than almost anyone.
Yep.
I mean, ooh, nice Chronosphere. Could catch out Envy, but Bulba catches out everyone with the Ravage. Manages to bypass the Chronosphere with a nice well-placed blink and resolution on the run. It's gonna get slowed down by the shivers, it looks like, and
what a way to go out, and what a way to win. Secret coming through as the our second winner's bracket finalists.
I feel like both teams still look like good, like DC still look like they played good Dota. Like,
yeah,
you got Alchemisted, which is not by any means to say like it's like a, oh, Alchemist, like you can't beat it or anything. Like, OS Frog, please, like the DC obviously.